Hey all, this is Ursa, and welcome back to the Long War. As we continue to move through this base, trying to get Egypt back in the fold, we know there's a pack right around here. So by golly gee willikers, we're gonna go in search of it and grab it and touch it. Let's see what we got.
Me muevo a la posición.
Me muevo.
Fuego.
Fuego. Ahí está un mectoid. ¿Por qué? All right, so yeah, we got a mectoid. That's fine. I mean, we can handle that. Can we pitch the proxy up on these little dudes? Oh, we can.
Oh, it must be my birthday.
All right, cool. We're gonna proxy combo the crap out of these guys because I don't like their face.
I don't like the way he looks. He doesn't like you.
Got it covered.
Hello, friends. Would you like to blow the Overwatch today? No, you wouldn't. So what is active here? It is 2 sector commanders, 1 mechtoid, and 3 little wee-toids. That's not supposed to be racist, it's just, come on guys, come on, racial sensitivity and sectoids, this is getting a little too PC, aren't we? Little weetoids. Let's go right about there, so we can proxy both of them. And I want to be mind controlled. The mectoid I can take off the plate, and it'll be okay. He's not a big mectoid, he's not special. You're not special, you know, my friend. We will do this. We're gonna command with Saint, so we can use Saint to do nasty, nasty things, namely set up the grenade combo. And everybody else gonna be gravy. Now, the thing is, with the mectoid, the mectoid don't see none. Yeah, nobody sees a mectoid. Look at that. All right, cool. This place is safe to move to. It's great. Good news. I like that. Okay, Saint, first and foremost, you're gonna command my mech. And we could go ahead and not blow the command yet, but it's totally fine. In this case, we should be fine. We're saving the big old explosives, namely rockets, for later. And the rest of this should be able to be handled, no problem. Really, I just don't want to get MC'd. That's my biggest worry. If we don't get MC'd, I'm happy. Yeah, that's what happens when you evaporate some stuff. You don't get MC'd. That's pretty much what happened there. We're not going to get MC'd. Okay. Well, that's job one done. We still have the Overwatch to run, but that's all right. Nova is going to combine for ludicrous amounts of kills here, provided she hits these 93s. Now, not a guarantee, but I think the odds are with her. No, Nova, high 90s are her weakness. Apparently, Nova can't hit shit at high 90s, so that frustrates me greatly. Saint, what do you got? If Saints hits these 66s, I'm gonna be cross with you, Nova. Like, literally, I'm very cross. He hit the 66. You know what else he's gonna do? He's gonna hit the next one. Never mind. He commanded. He can't do that. Okay, Dane.
Rolling.
Give me a little bit of Overwatch, and now it's just kind of waiting for the hammer to fall. Nova could have done so much work, but she failed again. I don't know, maybe she's getting tired of this. Maybe she's getting a little old, a little long in the tooth. Been doing this a long time. That aim ain't what it used to be. I don't know. I don't really understand why she's kind of sucking it up lately. It was kind of on the terror mission the same way. Maybe we should chop her or something. I don't know.
Defensive
at this point, it's kind of pointless. She's psychic, so we can't chop her. But I'm just kind of trying to put some kind of good-natured threat down so she understands that I'm not joking around here.
I'm on the move.
Because right now she's turning into a liability, which I'm not a fan of. Yeah, I mean, we can let Hank drop some bombs on us, which we're going to have to at this point. Since obviously no one else can. Very good, Hank. 12 damage. 15 damage. That's a very, very high roll for that gun. I like that a lot. Zhang, it'd be better off for him to be in full cover here. He'll take 2 shots, so he'll do that next turn if need be. You never know when something else comes. Ooh, there is something there. Whoa, 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 whoa. What is... Whoa, 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 Sunshine. What is this out here? This looks like it's a muton party. Ain't no party like a muton party. So, yeah, it looks like there's about 5, maybe 6. This guy's hunching a little. I think there may be 6 mutons on our right flank. If they move, we could be in a wee bit of a pickle. So I'm going to keep... watch out with the Zoidberg. I'm really lucky I didn't activate that, actually. That's kind of disconcerting. We'll see if they activate now. But luckily, Anakin, we have the high ground, so we should be fine. Let me pop Eggsland's cover. Eggsland's biggest weakness right now, and he has no movement, but he's otherwise pretty useful. You're gonna run the Overwatch for the big guy. That's a noble sacrifice, little sectoid. That's a noble sacrifice indeed.
X-ray neutralized.
X-ray myrtleized. And Saint's probably gonna take the shot from the mectoid, is my guess. Oh, he didn't get the shield. Really? I'm surprised you didn't give him the shield first. Yeah, there's the particle cannon doing the damage. Doing the nasty. 15 damage off of that thing. It's a way to melt a mectoid. That guy's like, screw this! I'm out of here. And for good reason. I'd be very, very afraid of what just came down the pipe, too. So we still have mech. So we took care of mech. Let me jot that one down. Took care of heavy mech. But we're still here in mech. There may be a second mech. That was a very extended noise notification, which makes me a little bit concerned. Just a wee bit. So we'll have to, we'll have to figure this one out. Alright, either way, mutons on the right side. That's what we need to deal with next. Get Dane. I don't want to trigger him yet, so let me take the opportunity to reload all the guns. Would Jung trigger this from here? He may. Let's find out.
Hostile spotted.
Yep, he did. I was banking on the fact that wouldn't happen, but that's alright. I did that now just to keep this one moving along a little better. I could wait and reload fully, but this pack we can handle without that.
Roger.
Nova's going to take point again. This would be one of those good times to use a blaster launcher that's effectively going to destroy all their cover. Alternatively, I can go ahead and drop a grenade. I'm going to pop that one first. Just because I'm going to see if I have the grenade withal to do that. It's kind of like wherewithal, but without grenades. See what I did there? All right. Yeah, well, no, we can get most of these guys down. And clear up some cover. This dude is a boss. He's kind of sitting up there kind of going, hey, okay, he's a boss creature, but I was kind of going like a boss kind of sort of situation. Can you see him, Hank? Yeah, you can see the big guy. Why is it 67 on all these? Hank's aim, is this something weird? Do you all have tac sense or something? Defense, low cover. They're just getting defense now. I think they've got some tac sense on them, or they're getting alien defense, which is going to start happening as the game moves on. It's not going to be standard aim protocols these days. Well, stuff's getting a little harder to hit. We're having trouble because the aliens are getting more intent on myrtleizing us. So we're gonna drop a grenade here, try to clear some cover and make Hank's job easier, and then if that doesn't work out, then we'll drop the high explosive. It looks like that didn't quite work out. Alright, really? Okay, how about we try this on for size? Fusion projectile. I guess they're non-explosive. I guess this cover doesn't break.
These colors don't run.
All right, whatever. Well, you're all gonna die, so enjoy.
Boom.
Might as well. That big muton's pretty tanky. I don't want to have to deal with him. So he's more a liability than anything else. Hey. Good. Okay, so that handles most of the mutons there. We should have two left, the guy in the front and the guy in the back. Nope, there is another dude we don't see, which is interesting. We do kind of want to get Saint up here, so I'm gonna use Saint kind of in this position. It is funny how that guy actually has cover. They're standing upright like a tool. I think if the animations are wrong, you should totally get credit for it. Like, that guy's definitely not in cover, so we shouldn't do it. I know, but for lack of a better idea for hitting stuff, why don't you just generate a little bit of plasma fire and holo for us? There you go. Yeah, high 90s are this girl's bane. Everything else, okay. Alright, what was the panic roll? 96. That'll work. You have executioner now, Zhang? You do. Yep. What's up? There's a 70-something miss.
I was not successful.
No shit. Alright, what else do we have? We have Odin. Alright, well, how about you smack him down? I need my Sleipnir! It's a Norwegian joke. Alright. Or, I guess, I don't know, Norwegian mythology? I don't even know anymore. Let's just go.
New position confirmed.
Nope, that's not going to help us move at all. That's kind of depressing. I don't want to grenade bait this too much because he does have grenades. He can't really do much with them, but he does have grenades. We could go right here, though, and have Dane suppress him so he can't really throw his grenade very far, and then he won't be able to do too much. This buddy behind him may. What other shots do we have? Zoid and Dane. What I may be able to do is combo this pretty well. I might be able to suppress, enforce the flush, and that way we can get a kill, and then we'll have just one muton remaining. I think that the flush combo may be useful. Saint, do you see that guy? You don't. Zoid, do you see that guy? No. Would you see it from here? You would.
Roger.
Okay.
Tracking.
So we're gonna set Zoid up here because he's got opportunist, and the likely result of this is gonna be a dead muton. That's the lowest roll I've seen the particle cannon yet. 7 damage. So we roll 15 or go down to 7. That's why... Yeah, plasma weapons are powerful, but just a wee bit unstable. Alright, Saint. Now, I would move Saint even further forward, but there could be another pack there. I'm just gonna sit back here with the pistol. We obviously don't have eyes on that little sectoid anymore, but Egg might be able to handle that if he comes back up. Alright. What do we got? No, he went down there to get the full cover. It makes sense.
They're falling back.
Who do you see, little guy? Do you see anyone? There's a miss on the Overwatch from...
Missed the target.
Yeah, that's a shame. That's a shame.
They've got me locked down.
Wow, he went after Zoidberg, huh? I don't know if that's really the wisest choice. He's not exactly the largest threat on the map right now. No knocking Zoidberg, obviously. Zoidberg's, you know, an animal, but... Seriously, as far as raw abuse and death is concerned, he's not the biggest concern, really. Might be able to do the same trick here. Let's go ahead and end the suppression with a nice bit of damage here. It's gonna be plus 2. I may run a second flush if we can.
My ammo's running low.
That's cool. We got the flush, right? Yeah, we got the flush. So we're gonna lock and load.
Ammunition loaded.
And we're gonna flush. And this should probably get a kill here. Gonna keep Zoidberg opportunisting as well. Maybe that'll work out. Get that flush. That sexy, sexy flush. Might be able to drop this with Hank first. Let me use the shot with Hank. That might save us time. 77 is pretty good. No, those high 70s just aren't really connecting for us. That's all right. Zhang's 82 might fly. That'll more or less guarantee the move once we flush. Nope. That's just, wow, we're just not really hitting much here.
Missed.
Newton's got some defense. I'll give him that much. This guy's dead now, though, so yay. Do we need to do that? I mean, we kind of do. Yeah, we kind of do. I don't really have much choice in the matter. Nova, do me a favor. And just... I feel like I want to move her and then get the motion track on. Let's just see. I got nothing up there, and I'm going to need to deal with that sectoid at some point. So why don't we get ourselves, like, right around... I want to know if there's anything else up this pipe.
On the move.
Yep, there's a pack on the left. Okay, there's definitely another pack on the left, so I'm glad I didn't go after that sector with anyone. That is what I needed to know. So we're going to keep doing this kind of the easy way, and I say this roughly speaking. 5 damage. 5 damage from that gun. That is the most unstable particle cannon I've ever had the displeasure of using. It really is not consistent with its damage output. Kind of hilarious, but now we know. If we take a look at the motion tracks, this is why we have intel and motion tracks for missions like this, folks. This is exactly why. This is straight up, so we're looking like a pack is going to be sitting right there on that crest. Right there. So we got to be ready for that. And that one we're going to reload before we even attempt. Because chances are it's going to be highly unfortunate, that pack. Alright, excellent. Can you cover
position
this little sectoid?
Confirmed.
Can you see him? You can see him. You can't, though. Oh, you can. Alright. What do we got? 50-50. Yeah. I'll probably take the 50-50. I mean, it's not crazy.
Solutions.
We have the pack on the left, so we're gonna edge to the right here. Saint's gonna have a 25. Yee. I don't like that 50-50, honestly. Excellent's a pretty good psychic. 59. Slightly better, but the mind free doesn't kill, and that's my... It's my only weakness. Let's put you right there. You're not gonna see the A. You're gonna see the A. Of course you're gonna see the A. I could blow a grenade on this little guy. I would hate to, though. It would seem quite excessive. I may blow a grenade here, though. Because this will pop the food. It's gonna cost me money, too, this little sectoid. I really don't want him to cost me money if I can avoid it. 38. Yeah, these odds aren't stellar. He's got in there pretty good. Maybe I'll just toss one of these grenades. Just don't want to blow up all the food. That's my biggest issue. I want to keep that food intact, if possible. I just want to clear his cover. So one of these foods is going to go down, but that's all right. Chances are the other pack's going to, you know, end the discussion anyway, but all right, that's fine. Excellent. You're fine there. Saint reload the pistol. You never know when you'll be handy. You can overwatch that. And we'll keep everyone reloading. We have that pack up there, and they're not going to move until we move into them. That's kind of the way this goes, usually. So lots of silence. We got one mech. Still more Muton. Okay, I'm starting to think we don't have another Muton pack, but we do have another mech pack. So we're currently looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 that I've heard. Silent drone, silent mech, Muton. And that would, you know, we're almost halfway through, which is pretty good. This next pack will put us about the halfway point on alien destruction. We still have a lot of heavy equipment to play with, so that's good. We haven't really burned all our CDs yet. We still have the flamethrower, which I may need to use very, very aggressively here in case this pack is an aggressive pack. Moving. We'll set up here. We'll move in with our tanky mech first, and since she can set up the explosives kind of on point. Satan has another command handy, does he not? Where is Saint these days? Where are you these days, Saint? That's Hank. That's not Saint. Alright, fine. You obviously don't want me to move the units I want to move, so that's okay. Stay up here. I'm going to probably set up Hank kind of up on one of these ridges here, on this non-destructible cover. Just kind of set up and set out that way.
Good to go.
He'll have a good vantage point across the entire thing. And that's going to be the advantage of having a full sniper here. We've had a wolf before, and it's kind of limiting the options when you can't really set up on like the cusp here and just go to town.
Locked and loaded.
I want Hank to have a good view here. I don't want to be instructed at all. So we're going to do it that way. Yeah, Cairo can kind of set up right around here. Yeah, Saint's right there. I'm going to see if he has another command handy once we get to his turn. Apparently they just don't want to let me select him, you know, by choice.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, Commander. Now again, this is all destructible cover, and being in the low ground is no good. We
Ready
could try and push up high ground, but that tends to get ourselves caught there. So we'll see what we do eventually. We may be using heavy explosives to make this work, but again, we'll feel it out. We still have one battle scanner and two motion tracks, so we'll be still good on CDs. Got my public enemies. All right, that is probably going to stay because our range on the rocket is, yeah, ridiculous. So we can do the whole room effectively. Yep. So anywhere they move, we'll be able to reach out and touch them. So we are just going to steady increase that range a little bit further. Because, you know, we're gluttons for punishment. Get that pistol out, actually, Saint. You never know when something runs up at us and we need a little bit of a mid-range engagement to make it happen. Ah, floaters. Interesting. Okay, so that may be a floater pack we didn't identify or a floater component to one of the other packs we already did identify. If I don't miss my guess, that's probably going to be a Warmaster pack. That's usually what they tend to throw at me these days. So, now there's a good argument to say that Hank could probably get here. I just don't want to get interfered by this full height cube. I want to go up here. So that'll be my next move with Hank,
move
if I can
out.
Swing it. Are you gene modded, Hank? You're not gene modded, are you? You know, I gotta start gene modding most of my snipers. They all need jumpy legs. Hank and whatchamahoozit. Natty Janitor and both need to get gene modded for jumpy legs. They're kind of slacking in that department. Keep you fine. I mean, I almost feel like I should put her out that way. This is not going to take vision. I'll be able to potentially get a nice flank from this if possible. I'll need to strategize exactly how I want to set people up, but this is going to be okay for Dane. Like if he had a heavy machine gun here, but that's not going to happen, so it's alright. Stay that up. And like I said, setup is everything here. I want to make sure that we can kind of do this nice and easy. Get Zoidberg. Zoidberg's not the critical one. Zhang, I need to get in position. Zhang is probably going to get in Saint's current position right now, so let me move Saint up kind of there. That may trigger, though, if they're literally on the cusp of being spotted, so put Zhang where Saint was, though. Definitely want him down here, if possible.
Going there now.
Be able to leapfrog full cover positions from here, and that's going to be more than enough. We also have PK Strike, remember, which is going to be critical if they really, really hunker down. An egg, again, is not the most critical unit here, so we're just going to lock him in the back, along with Zoidberg, and then we'll all scatter like cockroaches if something moves up, but for now, we should be all right. And again, you often want to lead with your scout. Oh, God damn it, I hate when I can't zoom in properly. You often want to lead with your scout because itchy triggered a tentacle on these things. I may still do that. It's just, I'm thinking Cairo just because she's so damn tanky, and Nova can work the ITZ especially if she gets a good angle, so I almost feel like it's better to use my mech, especially if I didn't take much damage. We had to use one medkit so far, almost halfway through this mission, so we're way ahead of the medkit train. Yep. All right, Hank, now the moment of la verdad. Let's see, can we get... I know it's not how you say it in Spanish, but shh, quiet. Let me get Hank right there, and as long as he doesn't trigger, we'll be okay. He didn't trigger, excellent. Hank can get here now. We checked the motion track, there's nothing up there, but we saw the unit there. So now Hank has clear vision on the entire room, and now we can set up for the breach. We're probably gonna breach from there next. All right, Egg. Everyone just stay where you are, actually. This is fine. Everyone's reloaded? Yep, okay. So we're just gonna steady up our Rocketeer, and we're gonna go to town next turn. We'll see what we've won, honestly. This will be pretty interesting. We could use a battle scanner, but I want to use that potentially for the last room. Because that room is big and tends to have 3 or 4 packs in there. We know there's floaters. Like, we know that. That's fine.
Did you hear that?
I did hear that. Now, the danger with the War Master, which makes me think I'm actually going to lead with my scout, is that they have heat ammo in general. And I don't want to have my mech take, like, 16 on a turn, because that would just be a waste of resources. So, we'll not do that. Still got more mutons. This could be a muton heavy floater pack, though, which would make things pretty interesting.
Got something over here.
No, this is straight up floaters, straight up heavies, and they all took high ground positions, and they are nasty. This is a meaty pack, legit. Sentry, so that's annoying, covering fire. Sentry. Wow, nothing but covering fire. War Master, and sentry. Nothing but sentries and war masters. Good God. And just one basic guy, but he has sapper. So all this is quite scary. All this is on high ground, and from what I can tell, on indestructible cover. So that's no bueno. Hank, what does your aim tell me? Your aim tells me that we're pretty fucked. Yeah, we don't have high ground on these guys. I mean, if there's any time for me to get Hank airborne, it's gonna be here. If this was anything but floaters, we'd be okay, but right now I need to get Hank away from them and on high ground relative to them. And this is gonna give me more bonus. We're almost out of flight fuel here. But now we have 92. If we need to drop bodies, we will. And we're gonna need to drop bodies like whoa. The good thing about this is that the basic guys, and this is why leading Nova's problematic, because now I have to run her out because of the flank. Yeah, the danger here, oh, they have bombard, dude, these guys are nasty. Danger here is just basically the heat ammo. Nothing else has it, so we could either go and blow the rocket, which is not going to change. It's not going to change anything here practically. It's not going to reduce their cover or anything of that nature, which bothers me. So we're going to need, or we can combo with a proxy just to do maximum abusive damage here. So we may need to go in hard, flamethrow a bit, and my mech is kind of in the worst position for this as well. No flanks available, nothing really doing save trouble. I mean, I might get a flank here, though. Might be able to flank. No, he's got cover from everything. So they're in a really hunkered down position. We can suppress a bunch, which helps. We do need to spread the hell out, though, because grenades are a thing. The only one with heat is that guy. As long as we can suppress him. Dane, do you have suppression on the guy? That's going to be clutch to know. Kinda, sorta? I think we will, because we're going to suppress the front guy. We'll be able to get the back guy. Alright, so my plan is going to be to shift Cairo up in Ye direction. I don't want to take any... I mean, this would be blocking her vision, but I don't want to necessarily take positions away from people that can take full cover. So, I need to take full cover, rather. We're going to go... I mean, I would like to go ahead and potentially shred here, but if I'm going to combo the grenades and do ludicrous damage, I'm going to need the actual weapon... Actual weapon, meaning the actual blaster launcher, high explosive, to get that one set off. I think Saint's Command is still on cooldown. This is one of those packs where Command makes total sense, blowing a good cooldown. No, it's actually still active, which is a boon and a half. Yeah, this room is very flankable. We have 90 degree cover, but they've cheated up so far that flankability is a thing. Deary me. It's quite the predicament. Let's put Zhang here. Now, the good thing about Zhang is he can clear this cover, and we could probably get some nice shots to drop that guy. That command. I still wonder whether that command is worth it. I'm leaning toward abso-frickin-lutely. Yeah, I'm leaning toward absolutely necessary. So we're gonna go command. So we're gonna shred, and then we're gonna blow. Oops, wrong button. And then we're gonna blow the thing with a grenade, and maybe we can evaporate the War Master. That's job one. We heard more heavy mech, though. The shred may be useful, but these guys are just so freaking scary. I don't even want to play around with this. The heavy mech is almost easier to deal with, because Dane can just heat it to death. These things can't be heated. Can I get Shredder on everybody? No. Just the front two. And that's fine. That's where the War Master is, and that's where the real threat is. So let me get the Shredder right on point.
Boom.
This won't feel good. What's up? Oh, he even took the shred. I didn't expect that. Great, that's good news. Unexpectedly good news, actually. All right, and now let's go ahead and launch the grenade. And we'll probably evaporate the front guy. Don't know we'll get the back guy, though. The back guy could give us a little bit of a problem. So you give him right on the run of his feet there. Well, if he had feet. What's up? Okay, evaporated the front guy. Back guy's got 3 HP. That's probably deal withable with Hank. But before we do that, I may need to drop the guy that's on the verge of flanking us on the floor here. As much as I want Zhang to start unloading rounds, that may not be the best use of his talents right now. So you've got 4 insight. Dane, you have 1 insight. That guy. You know, I could totally... So we don't have suppression on that fellow? No, we don't, actually. Interesting. I'm trying to think. If we miss this shot on this guy, I don't want him healing, because he's gonna heal. I don't know, Saints Running Gun is looking better and better every minute right now. Just go ahead and just straight up, just waste a fool. And then he'll have CQC on the rest of them. And Saint can handle... If anyone can stand toe-to-toe with like 4 heavy floaters, it's Saint. So I think I'm actually going to run that. I'm going to go aggressive, drop this guy. And we'll be able to fan out and support Saint with this. Drop that guy. This fellow may be problematic, but Hank can put some pain on him. I think this will work, actually. Let me get Saint up here. Saint's uncritable. He's uncritable, and we have a lot of medkits, so I'm pretty confident about this. Probably should have checked yet CQC. I mean, I haven't seen them with that yet, but it's highly possible they would end up with that. Хорошо. And now we have options. So Dane, can we suppress the guy that would probably run up on Saint? Zhang has eyes on the guy from here, right? He's Zhang on all 4. He has Zhang on all 4. Wow. I'm losing my mind. He has eyes on all 4. I need to see... Where's Dane? For God's sake, can I please just click Dane? Thank you. Sometimes with a lot of units, it gets annoying. I need to see if that green circle comes up under that guy if we go here. I think it does? Yes, it does. Okay. I think it does. Put Dane right there.
I'm on it, Commander.
With backup suppression if need be. Perfect. So Zhang, we're actually going to use you to PK this food. He is now uncovered and, as far as I can tell, not flying. Bing freaking go. And was his name-o. We're going to get right up here. And this is going to prevent Nova's flank, and we can also kind of converge for a lot of ITZ work. Good damage. Good damage. Now, we could go ahead and try an ITZ with Hank, which is probably the best move here, and save the flush and maybe another ITZ chain for the other thing. Roll well, Hank. Roll well. Hank rolls well. Very nice shot. 20 crit. Maybe it says brutalized or neutralized. I'm not really entirely certain, but either way, I'm pretty happy with it. All right, let me get this flushed. 8 damage on the flush. God damn, that gun's a beast. All right, nice. So we don't have suppression on the guy now, but we may have a kill on the guy. We're lucky. 92. Yeah, Hank might be able to pull that off. He just gets... if we get the 66... That looks pretty good if we get the 66, actually. If not, we just get the hollow at least. We got the hollow at least, and that's... I'm going to live with that. I can live with that. All right, Hank, now... 100% chance to connect on this guy. There's another kill from our Angel of Death. So worth it to put Hank up in the air. That's his last charge, though, so that's a little worrisome. Gonna keep your head down a bit. Then we're probably gonna go either double tap you next turn, or we're gonna use PK to drop the cover. Zoidberg is going to be able to provide opportunist cover here, and I don't want to put him out here because the flank is possible, especially if they run it, so I'm going to put Zoidberg right there. Give us covering fire if they try to rush Saint. Egg is going to go... It is possible still that there could be something else out here, so I'm going to put Egg up here for the support grenades if need be. We'll see what's going to happen. Now, these guys should be pretty panicked at this point. We've pretty much dropped most of their power. And, yeah, they're not in a good spot. Not in a good spot. So they're not doing anything? Or they just haven't hit their turn yet? They haven't hit their turn yet. I was wondering, they just kind of panic and then do it. He's running it. Exactly why I gotta be careful about where you put people, because they can run it and try for the flank, which was I think is exactly what he's trying to do. He's trying to get up. He's trying to get at Hank, I think. No, he opened himself up to a... Did he land that? That would be double flank. So he's... Okay. Yeah, both of these guys up and flanked themselves, which... I think that was a bug in the AI, because there's no way they're that stupid on a regular basis. That's kind of just fortunate for us. They could be baiting us into another pack, though, which I'd be very suspicious of. They could well be baiting us into another pack here. Where? Come on. There was a part where I saw that guy. Okay, there's a part where I see him here, but not that guy. Wow, really? Okay, so the AI is cleverer than I thought. Basically, we're in a position where I can only see one of them with my murder machine. I mean, Excellence still has flanks on this. It's not like this is the end of the world, but it's just kind of funny how that works. Hi. Good crit, Egg. Nice shot. Yeah, Excellence hasn't really fired his gun a lot on these missions, I've found. Kind of humorous, really.
Yes, ma'am.
We won't take too much more vision here, so I put Saint... Ah! Son of a bitch, they were baiting us. I didn't think Saint would peek that if there was anything to peek. And turns out there was. There's a cyber disk, but a basic cyber disk. So this is, I think, one of the silent packs, even though the cyber disk was technically should have been the one we've been hearing. But again, not a threatening pack, only one saber disk, some basic drones and seekers. Nothing too scary, but this is the bait, man. I smelled the bait, and I decided it didn't matter. He's got Saint in the front line, so it really, really, really doesn't matter. And Hank can probably just vaporize most of those. Just straight off. Yeah, 12 damage high. As long as we roll okay, we'll be good. Now, that's not a guarantee within and of itself, but it is something. We have what? I want to lock and load, because we have another pack active now, so... Let's go ahead and ping this guy if we can. Got the 88. Got such a good-looking gun. We wrecked another food, which is expected. These don't last very long. They are pretty fragile little bumpkins, so...
Okay.
All right, Dane. What I actually might do is suppress AoE here. We probably get some damage on a couple of these guys. Just like that, baby. Just like that. I wanted to weaken them all for Hank, and now we have a shooting smorgasbord. Yep! Now we have a shooting smorgasbord. Hank, just count them all for me. Oh god, this is going to be so abusive. Every single one of these units is dead this turn. So good. So good. Reload. Then we're going to have some fun. I'll make sure I have a full clip for this, otherwise we may not have enough damage. I mean, enough ammo. This room in Archangel Snipers. It's good soup. What's the next highest? Now we only have ones and twos, so alright. I'm going to leave the last shot for the Seeker. That's the only one I can actually miss, because he's a little more evasive than the rest of them. Yep. And this is how we get the tracking modules. Basically, we just have drones, and Hank just gets to play target practice with these. I think we actually have drones back at XCOM HQ for target practice for our snipers, so this becomes a regular occurrence. Like, this is just... Oh, that suppression. Worth its weight in gold right there. That was the most perfect way to deal with his entire pack. Look at this crap. I needed a full clip, because that was 6 shots, 6 kills for Hank. That was ridiculous, man. That's just unfair. And reloaded back up. 6 shots, or 5 shots? I think 5 shots, 5 kills. That's just insane, man. Hank is a freaking beast.
Moving.
Okay. And we're going to watch for the Overwatch on the cyber disk. It's a basic cyber disk, so it shouldn't have heat. Likely won't take any damage. Say, you'll probably pitch a grenade at something that's bunched. They tend to do that when they really have no other option. They can't really close on us with distance, so that's probably what they're gonna do. Yeah, this is like one tile thing. It's really bugging me. I can't really quite get cover. I could get cover with Zoidberg up this way, get him some high ground in case that Cyberdisc becomes annoying. Probably gonna do that. Give me high ground on Zoidberg.
Moving to designated coordinates.
But we're moving through. We're moving through pretty well. Moved through in a lot of packs already, so this is all well and good. Nova just flumped to the side here. And we're gonna set an overwatch here. And Meepy's like, yeah, my rockets, they're always on point. Yep, blaster launcher is a beautiful thing. So we're out of shred. We still have a heavy mech out there, but we have heat to deal with the heavy mech. The shred is kind of critical for dealing with heavy floaters, just to make them not exist anymore. But yeah, I'm gonna assume this is a silent pack or a drone. It's maybe the drone pack, actually. Let's say it's the drone pack. Definitely have the mech, definitely have the muton, I think another silent pack. This is the one we heard the drone sounds from, I'm relatively sure. It's funny how holo doesn't apply on the Overwatch phase. I think it should. It's not like you need to flip a switch, I think it's almost like always on the gun. One of those readouts for your ops glasses or something. I don't know, that's the way I always thought of holo targeting. It seems odd that you need to do it deliberately. What are you doing? Oh, Saint. I was wondering, who the hell's over there? Oh yeah, Saint is. He's gonna do like one damage or two. Three. Oh, he got lucky. Saint, he got really lucky doing that much damage to Saint. Normally that would not fly. Saint would kind of take that off the plate. It was a bigger grenade, bigger load. They heard about Saint, they're like, dude, we need something bigger to deal with this guy. He's a freaking beast. And that's pretty much true. Alright, so we're gonna go drop this guy now. We're not gonna get hit and run options. For obvious reasons. He's floating. But everything else still holds true. Can't get eyes with Zoidberg. Can't really get grenades on this thing. I could go up here and threaten it this way, assuming there's nothing else here. Now, the doorway is right there. My gut is that there's nothing else here. We would have triggered it already, so I'm going to go up and move here. It's a little concerning, yes, but I think we'll be okay. And I think we're going to unload this gun as the first one, unless Dane can get an eye, because heat in the beginning would be perfect. Dane, can you get to a place that's safe that can give you an eye on this thing? Yep, you can get full cover and an eye on the cyber disc. Works good for me. I don't think I have the ammo for suppression. I do even have ammo for suppression. Okay, nice. We could try to burn it down or just suppress it. I'm gonna try to burn it down. Nice shot. I'm glad that 60% hit. That makes this a lot easier. Now, I should be able to bounce a grenade in such a way as to hit it off of the plate here. I can kind of get it off the wall, I think. Maybe. Let me see. It's 50-50 on whether that's going to be possible. Maybe a little less than 50-50. But let me see what I can do. I mean, worst comes to worst, I'm going to take a shot at it. But if I can bounce that grenade off of the wall somewhere, kind of like up in this direction, no, it's going to... I'm just going to get it on the very edge of the grenade. 75 is pretty good, especially with the holo. Beth, what are you looking at? You're looking at 98. God damn! Girl, that aim! Girl, that aim! What? Nova's fine. Zhang is just a couple tiles back. So, Nova, get up here. Improve the aim on the cyber disc so we can clear this up nice and easy. I don't want to have any really obviously missed shots. Zhang can get back here, and I'm relatively certain he'll see from here because Nova just did. Bingo! How's it looking? 91. If we can get him to executioner range, that becomes a guarantee. So I'm going to try to take a couple shots. Probably one on Beth here. To bring it down, executioner. Whew, yeah. Watch that pierce that ammo. 8 armor, 8 damage, 5 DR. It's a big DR. It's a tanky one. Which one is this exactly? Let me see. Gunstar. Yeah, this is the one that does a lot of damage with guns. Hence the name. He's got light him up. Not gonna matter. Hank's got 100%. Yeah, he do. Really don't matter who gets this kill, but Zhang hasn't gotten a really big kill yet this mission, I think. Now that, my friends, is DR. 6 DR, only 2 damage off of a heavy plasma rifle. Scary. Cairo? 5 and 5. Yeah, these things are tanky. This is why you normally bring shreds for hard targets like this. So I'm kind of glad we have a lot of good aim available. Nova's got it.
He's down.
Yeah, that took a lot. I mean, that thing DR'd across, like, I don't know, 20 damage? That's insane.
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah! Oh, no! Is that the last thing that's active? Yeah, 33 aliens killed. All right, so they're probably all hanging out in the last room. Oh, yeah. We're probably looking at four packs-ish. Four or three really big packs. Probably going to be four smaller packs, though.
Ideal, sir.
But we've seen like seven, like two or three seven-unit packs before in the last room. All right, deflight yourself. So we should be at one flight fuel currently, yeah. One flight fuel. So that's a little low for the rest of this mission, but as long as we get him into a good position in that last room first, our first move is going to be critical for Hank. If we can do that, fine, then we'll be all right. And Zoidberg, go up here. I kind of want to top off Saint, but he really didn't take much damage. Understood. We have so much on the medkit side. We have 60 HP worth of healing still. I could totally spend 10 of it to top off Saint, because we're going to be pushing him some bad positions. I don't want it to be one of those. Oh, if only he had one more HP, he would have lived, and we have a freaking memorial service, and that would just be depressing. So yeah, one of those. Okay, still got Muton, still got Heavy Mech, and I'm guessing a Silent Pack, which is a Command Pack. So that could well be just three more big ones, because that would be 21. Each pop about seven aliens. That would be the population, the average population of a base. So, and we could be on the home stretch, which is nice. Probably all in the last room. I would probably put my money on it at this point now that I'm doing the count more precisely. I would probably say three big packs. That's far more likely. It's just one of those things I kind of feel. XCOM, in the last room especially, like to send big packs on you so you have trouble hitting that beachhead. And often with a level 9 boss of some sort. We've only seen one so far. I'm a little concerned the level 9 in this one is going to be a Muton, and I don't think we've seen a level 9 Muton yet.
Oh, it's gonna hurt.
I'm not sure if the guy on the right there, the green boy, was actually level 9 or he was just, I don't know, just a kind of a beast. One of those commanding guys, the Centurions. Because they're not level 9, the Centurions. They're close, but they're not absolute beast mode fellows.
Recargando las armas.
They do have the accents right, though. That makes me happy.
Bye-bye.
Onward, everyone.
On the move.
Yeah, we're just all just trying to catch up now. It's all sprinting.
Understood. Moving out.
Good.
Hey, you hear anything?
Say what now? Okay. Yeah, two silent packs. You saw that, right? Two gaps. I heard something right here. That's not possible. So it means it's right there. That's the nearest pack currently to us. So the beachhead is gonna have to be made to the right, and it's gonna be all the way out here. Unless they're, no, but they can't be here. There's no way it can be here. That should be too weird. I'm gonna wait to end this particular episode until we open this last room here. And then we'll set up for the breach probably next time. But, I mean, this is a weird... That's a weird signal to get. It's a weird signal to get already here. They may be... Oh, you know what it may be? It may be a floating pack that's either sitting in the gap between the rooms right up here, if that's actually floatable. Or it could be sitting kind of right at the very, very, very bleeding edge. We may try and toss a battle scanner. Maybe be able to take advantage of Hank to blow it up. Meepy as well. It's interesting, actually. I never seen that trigger that early, I don't think. Especially not this campaign. Interesting. Things you still learn about alien bases, I guess. Goddamn. Things are scary, full of surprises in a bad way. I'll be breaching. Hank will be setting.
Affirmative. Moving out.
Anything else? That's it. Alright, everyone else just overwatch. And we're gonna pop open the door. But yeah, I'm thinking it's gonna be on that right edge. We will definitely check a motion track to make sure there's nothing on our west. I don't like how that just randomly came up. It'd be awful if that was a sectopod pack. They can just kind of bombard us before we make the beachhead. That'd be brutal. That would be like D-Day stuff. All right, so there's nothing in there. It is going to be in the last room, and we'll handle that next time. Thank you so much for tuning in this episode of The Long War as we continue the alien base raid. Let's bring this sucker home. I've been Nurse. Till next time. Till then.